Game 5 between Cleveland and Boston had much more at stake than we possibly could have imagined 10 days ago. The Celtics exposed some of the Cavs' vulnerabilities over the first four games, and then there was the matter of LeBron James, who at least theoretically could have been playing his last home game as a Cavalier Tuesday night at the Q. It was one of the biggest games of James's career, but things couldn't have gone much worse. The Cavs were embarrassed by the C's, and James scored only 15 points, going 3-for-14 from the field. The question on everyone's mind, of course, is what went wrong for LeBron? Early on, it just looked like one of those games where James acts as a facilitator. But there were also some warning signs. Maybe it was a teammate, like Mo Williams here, missing an opportunity to involve James in an easy break. Or maybe it was the aggressive Boston defense that doubled him even well beyond the arc. Whatever the reason, it was clear early on that James was unusually tentative with the ball. You can see him here, almost demure when confronted one-on-one by Paul Pierce. And when he wasn't reluctant to attack, he was completely uninvolved in the offense. On this possession, like many others Tuesday night, James is an afterthought, drifting around on the weak side like a guy who doesn't need the ball. The game is almost 13 minutes old before James makes his first really assertive drive to the basket. That's particularly strange because James couldn't buy a jump shot all night. He went 1-for-11 from outside the paint and was short on just about every single miss. There were times when James didn't seem completely in control and his handle was sketchy. Here he drops the ball in traffic, only to recover it as the shot clock ticks to 1. And here he's all over the place, only to be rescued by a bailout whistle. On this possession, James throws an errant pass out of bounds, trying to lob the ball to a rolling Anderson Varejao. There were some strange lapses defensively as well, especially after James picked up his third foul early in the third quarter. James averaged only about a foul and a half per game in the regular season. Watch this play. The Cleveland defense gets crossed up as both Anton Jameson and Shaquille O'Neal step out to the perimeter to cover the screen and roll. This leaves the Cavs vulnerable on the weak side, which is why Kendrick Perkins calls for the ball underneath. You can see that James is now responsible for Perkins, but take a look at what happens. James essentially steps aside, leaving Jameson to run back and do damage control on Perkins. Here's the next possession. James draws Rondo on the switch. James then motions emphatically for Mo Williams to recover back onto Rondo. Now, maybe James is concerned about the Pierce-Mo Williams mismatch, but Rondo doesn't care. While James is working out the seating chart, Rondo dashes to the hoop for a layup. Who can say for certain why LeBron James turned in this kind of effort on such a big night? It's worth noting he took off his elbow guard to start the fourth quarter, and on repeated occasions, LeBron looked white. After the game, James refused to explain away his failure.
And you know, for me, I'm not an excuse guy, and the fact that I spoil a lot of people with my play. You have a bad game here or there, you had three bad games in a seven-year career, then, it's easy to point that out. So, just got to be better. Me, I put a lot of pressure on myself to be out there and try to be great, be the best player on the court. And when I'm not, then I feel bad for myself, because I'm not going out there and doing the things that I know I can do. But I don't hang my head low or make excuses about anything that may be going on, because that's just not the type of player and the type of person I am.